Sam and Christy had a rule of no exposition, and so everything, it's just little kind of little bits and bobs that you pick up on the way. But from the story is so present, and the film is so present, but I think the crux of Schofield's character is where he's from, and what he's missing, basically. And I think that's what the film's about, is how these extreme situations, in any case, teach you about what you go back to. So for me, yeah, it was essential to know what all of those things were, and that was through a mixture of research. You know, I came here, you know, reading first-person accounts, and then also just building it myself. And there was kind of lots of different ways. I got into, through Dennis Gassner, the production designer, I got into Stanley Spencer, and Paul Nash, you know, I think his painting's here. And Stanley Spencer's from a place called Cookham, so I actually thought that Schofield was from Cookham, which is where Stanley Spencer's gallery is from. And I used to go down there, and there's lots of stuff that I used to do just for myself. But yeah, it was essential that I knew all of the little bits that you find out in the film. The sets were so incredible that to just get lost in a scene or a place for 10 minutes, it was kind of easy to do that, because No Man's Land was... I mean, it was abominable. Like it's incredible the work that was done, and all we had to do was be in it. And that kind of those long periods of just letting go of all the technicality was allowed us to do that. And that's kind of what gave us as close to a real person account as we could have got.